Welcome to our weekly Forex and Futures Forecast. My name is Jay Norris. I teach trading at Trading University. As always, we need to remind you that trading involves risk of loss and it's not suitable for everybody. Into the new year, we're going to add a new page to the videos where we'll actually go back and track the day trades that the Trading University method generated over the week. And we know that this will be a big help to our current students because it will provide a benchmark that they can compare their own trades to. Speaking of the previous week's trades, here's a snapshot of several four-hour charts, and this is exactly how we teach it during the week. And you could really see the symmetry and timing of these moves here, where the market had a nice impulse move and then a somewhat lengthy correction. The market bottomed out here at a predictable level. Similar, the euro did the same thing, impulse move down, lengthy correction, market tops out at a specific level. And our students, they know exactly what makes these levels important to us. These are risk tolerance threshold levels. And fantastic the way the market bottomed. The dollar pairs bottomed right on them this week. The euro topped right on them. So we definitely see market movement as predictable. And our students definitely know what it is that made those levels risk tolerance threshold levels, and they know how to mark those levels out before price gets there and respects those levels and shifts momentum and reverses against them. So we look forward to the new year. It's been a great year, and I want to thank all our students for making it so. Boy, when you guys participate in classes like you did this week, it makes it so much more fun for me to teach those classes. Okay, we'll get on with the report here. First market we're going to cover will be the Australian US dollar. We'll give you a daily chart of that. What do we show you this week? We showed you that level last week. Speaking of risk tolerance threshold levels, there's a beauty from last week. Market topped right on it. You couldn't get through it, and so the market reversed pretty hard. So that being said, we think you will see lower lows in this market. We think that that 50% level, we understand why that held. Let me pan all the way out to a weekly chart to show you. That's the 50% retracement of this entire bull run going back all the way to the 09 low. No doubt about it. That's a heady level. That's a big, big level. We think overall that you'll penetrate that level overall, and we think our longer-term target is 80. Now, there's a lot of room below in the Australian dollar for us. 80, that's a mouthful, right? However, we're not as bared up on this market as we are on the euro. We think there's a lot more downside percentage-wise on the euro. So the Aussie recovered later in the week. However, we think that you're still going to see some downside here. At the very least, you'll get another test of that 80, of that 85.30 level, and it wouldn't surprise us if you even fish around down below there, start to probe below that level. Next market is the dollar Swiss. Look at that big, big rally there. You can see our risk tolerance threshold level market bottom right on it. You know, you open up the upside, and what have we been seeing now for months? We think par. We think par is in the cards for this market overall. Now, it looks like that it'd be a big rally. You know, you've come a long, long way. But as we always say, when you put these markets in perspective, pop out to a monthly chart, and there you go. Par's not that far away at all. So that's where we're leaning. We think you'll see a test of that of the 2012 high in the dollar switch, which happens to be right at the 100 level, right at the power level. X market dollar index. And keep in mind, when we say buy dips, we don't necessarily mean you're waiting for a dip on a weekly chart or a daily chart. By the way, that's why we work off the intraday charts, because you get plenty of opportunities as the market plays back and forth. They haven't repealed the law of gravity by any means in these markets. So you get a lot of play. You get a lot of intraday play back and forth throughout the week. And that's what we're here to take advantage of at Trading University. And here's the dollar index. There's my upside target there. And we say, hey, you know, why not by year end? Granted, you'll have a slow week. Now you've got the U.S. holiday, the U.S. Thanksgiving holiday, and that opens the door to, of course, the Christmas holidays. There's still quite a bit of trading left in December, I suspect, and we think that overall you'll keep on chugging higher here, and you'll see that 90 level in the dollar index. X market, the euro. There's the euro, and you can see I still have lines on here when I was teaching that. It's not uncommon for markets to give you three pushes in a move. A lot of Elliott guys will recognize that for the Elliott pattern. Can guys too, and that's just what markets do. However, it's never quite as neat as it is in Prechter's book, where you get the perfect wave pattern down. But nonetheless, you often do get three patterns down in a move, and we think that you began that third pattern this Friday. You can see, and we think that certainly will open the door to lower prices. You nearly made a lower low here. Is that it looks like probably a lower low. A lower low settlement on the weekly chart. Yeah, there it is. That's a new multi-year low settle on the weekly chart. So, 120, not that far away by any stretch. And when you pan out longer term, I have to switch to a futures chart to get more history for this guy. You can see, boy, there's plenty of room below here. Let me take it all the way out to a weekly, monthly chart for you. There's a GAN 625 line. We think you'll penetrate that too. So longer term, we think you're going to see 110. So a lot of room down below in the euro US dollar for our money for sure. Here's the gold market. Gold, interesting. You had that recovery. We called that bottom there. Look at that. To the T, it hit that long-term trend line. Let me pull up a monthly so you can see that. It hit that GAN 5/8 line. You can't dismiss GAN, that's for sure. There's enough old timers in the back rooms around Wall Street that they still go to these old guys and, hey, what's that level again? And sure enough, look at that level. There's your GAN 5/8 line. Take that low, that high, and market bottom right on 5/8. And it happened to bottom right on a trend line too. So big level for gold to hold. But typical of a counter trend market, you find a support level and you get the market starts to bottom out, some players take their profits short term. You turn that market around, you run some shorts out, it gets right into a risk tolerance threshold level. There you can see our risk tolerance threshold level right there, the orange box. And you get traders that had the right idea, investors that had the right idea to be short that market. You get them to start questioning their positions. Maybe guys that got short in here on this last leg down, now they're breaking even, they don't want to take a loss. Guess what? It goes just far enough to run them out. Market tops out and rolls back lower. So that's what we'd be betting on here. We don't see anything having changed in the big picture, the macro picture, that's propelling the dollar higher. Speaking of commodities, we'll show you crude oil too. But yeah, as far as we're concerned, we'd be looking to set up gold shorts as long as price is in that box. You had a couple closes above that box, so, and that would spelled probably a little bit longer term of a correction. We'd probably move on out towards that 1250 high, and we would definitely see a double top at that level. If we like selling it, if we like shorting gold in the box here, if it clears that box, we love shorting a double top at 1250. Let me show you crude oil, which the dollar rally came before the crude oil sell-off. Well, it's definitely, markets are a two-way mechanism, no doubt about it. Lower crude oil prices is going to support a stronger dollar, just as the stronger dollar really pulled the rug on crude prices too. But you can see crude bottom right on that long-term 50% level. Here, I'll pan all the way out to monthly so you can see where that level came from. And we talked about this, the possibility of a dollar correction based on the commodity correction, and commodities really aren't correcting. They paused at that level, but they're really only going sideways. And there's back to a daily crude oil chart. You can see you had a little bit of a hiccup here, a little bit of a dead cat bounce on the daily, but it really couldn't hold the gains. When you look at an hourly chart, it looked like, hey, that was it's probably an opportunity to get short here. In fact, here I'll show you exactly where that line topped out at, and our students, they understand where that line's coming from too. You take that high, right? You take the high to the low, and guess where it topped out at? Bam! Look at that, right on our risk tolerance threshold level there. So we think that's a dead cat bounce in the crude oil. Although, longer term, you're so close to year end. Longer term, I don't know how much sense it makes to hold long term shorts here, given it's consolidating on that 50% level. But overall, we think you're going to continue to see lower lows here. I think 64 even is going to be the overall target for crude oil. Last market to cover dollar yen. And dollar yen, really, it's crazy, right? I mean, it's just a market where we've been pointing out, hey, this has been a leading indicator market the whole way up the last couple of years. Look at going back all the way down to where it bottomed at 80. Now it's at 117. This is what the dollar can do when when everything lines up against another currency and you have that other currency's central bank cheerleading the demise of their own currency, which is what we're seeing in Europe now also. So this is what the dollar can do against other currencies. So really, this is this is the model right here. This rally in the dollar yen is the model for us for the rally in the dollar. Hey, thank you so much. My name is Jay Norris. We look forward to seeing you again next week. We will be here after the Thanksgiving holiday. We'll do a report for you. And we're certainly looking forward to our year-end break at Trading University. And hey, thanks again to all our students for making this week a great week of teaching for me and certainly profitable for a lot of you guys too. Hey, thanks so much, and we'll catch you next time. Bye-bye.